have about 75, 80 participants during the day when we're at full capacity coming into this room. This is the original floor from the temple, so they tried to preserve little touches of the temple here and there. As we go through, I'll try to point them out if I remember. We have the capability of projecting onto the big screen here, so we can show movies.
I'm not quite so I can't join this kind of
fun stuff on the screen.
I like the fireplace.
Yeah, behind it we have a gas fireplace. So on and off in the touch of a button, which is really nice. And then the big, beautiful windows open up to a garden outside, which is really nice. And they have access to full access to the garden. It's all fenced in, which is nice and secure. So you can wander kind of outside. We'll have outdoor patio furniture. The larger room. So if this gets a little too crowded and chaotic during the day, we have a smaller activity programming room over here. The colors are very soothing, you'll notice as you walk through here. It's all like the pale blues and greens.
This is very nice. So here is our East activity room.
So in here is a little quieter programming.
I love the high windows. I love that.
And then in the back we have a library here where the participants can come in. We'll have a full complement of books soon where they can come in and just have a nice quiet space. It's like double quiet.
Yeah.
Nice intimate setting. So we just have a lot of these rooms scattered throughout the center. Yeah. So that all of our social work staff are LICSWs and do counseling with our participants, so that these are smaller counseling rooms where they can just bring the participants in and, you know, meet for counseling, meet with families, you know, away from the space where they can just have a quieter room, away from, you know, the crowd.
Did you learn a lot from other facilities? Did you visit a lot of places and say, oh, I like this, I like this, I don't
Absolutely.
Like this?
Yeah. I come from Pace, Rhode Island.
Okay.
Our medical director comes from a Pace site, and Kathy has done her share of kind of bebopping around through Pace sites, too. And I think in Mattapan there's a lot of lessons learned, too.
Yeah.
So we absolutely did research, not myself. I can't take credit for that. I only started here a few months ago, but they did a lot of lessons learned. And I think when they set up this center, the architect and the designer was also a registered nurse, so she used a lot of her nursing background, too, to really make sense of the space. This artwork here was from a participant's family in Mattapan. Her mom had passed away, so she donated the artwork.
Oh,
that's
lovely. Nice.
The rest of our artwork will be coming from Art Connection.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
Through here is our warming kitchen.
How are you? Welcome.
We do hot holding for our participants, so our food comes in through City Fresh. And we do hot holding and then just serve it restaurant style to our participants here.
We
can serve about 25 participants right now. A hospital comes out of a nursing home. We're concerned about how they may do at home. We can set them up in the training kitchen to see, make sure they can use a microwave safely, see how they'll do on the stove, and have a little trial run.
I apologize for the box in the middle of unpacking.
We're currently going through licensing, but we're hoping for August 1st to move. It's the first of the month rule, so we can't enroll before.
Oh, yeah,
and we missed
right.
July, so
yeah.
We're hoping for August 1st. Down here are just some restrooms. Our laundry room is here. Anyone want to see the laundry room?
Sure.
So
welcome to the original structure. So when they brought the ceiling down, they had a
around
the wheel and had the plaster
around
the
circles like this, trying to get the plaster smooth. So I don't envy his job. I don't think I could have tolerated that, but he did a nice job. It was really smooth in there. And it is kind of a focal point.
And are we going to look for a Michelangelo to
be
painting?
No,
that would have done about two swirls and that didn't say what happened.
No signature.
Yeah. The Pope kept saying, when will you be finished? When will you be finished?
So this is the beginning of our medical clinic, we obviously have emergency crash carts and ready for anything, hopefully, here. This is our RN and MA office in here. So this is where the nurses will do their charting, and we'll have a medical assistant that's seated out front. I'm hit you right in the face on film, too. Jeez. You'll edit that out, right?
Yeah.
So the MA will sit out front and act as a receptionist for the medical clinic. We do have a med room here, and this is mostly for emergency medications and immunizations on this side. The other side.
And then what do you have, like, set hours, like 8 in the morning till 6 at night, or what?
Right now it's 7 to 5.
Oh, 7 to 5.
Right. Monday through Friday. Mm-hmm. Eventually, I assume that we'll open Saturday. I think there is a need, or will be a need, for Saturday programming. We do have the ability to do respite on Saturday, should participants' families need that. But right now, we're Monday through Friday. Mm-hmm. And, of course, we do service 24/7, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, but as an on-call basis. So after we close here, we do have nurses on call after hours, and then physicians on call also. And we do provide 24-hour care in the home.
Nice.
This is just storage for medical supplies. We have our clean utility here, which is really just all of our linens, oxygen is in here, and then dirty utility here, which is our biohazard. Mm-hmm. And then we have another treatment room here at the end of the hall, which is another room.
Has this nice clean room.
And you must have to have all redundant backup systems in terms of emergency lights and all of that.
Yeah, we have a generator. You'll notice as we walk, there's red plugs here and there. Those were all our generator plugs. We do have a ton of backup systems here. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Take you off through this door here. We do have an elevator to mid-level and then go right out through this entrance here. Mm-hmm. So the ambulance can pull up here. I've taken them out by stretcher and then just go right out.
The nice thing about this also is that the projecting screens, and we also have two screens that come down from the ceiling. And the tables are movable.
They're
all
like this.
Yeah,
I like how
these tables.
They fold up.
Yeah, they fold up. They're stackable. So we'll meet every day to discuss, issues, problems with participants, problems participants may be having, service requests. If a participant wants to come to the center, say, more often or less often, we'll talk about those. And then we also talk about team. How is our team functioning? Is our team getting along well? Are we having any issues? Are we hearing each other? We talk about issues in the home, issues in the center. Just a lot of problem solving around our participants. We really just like to stay connected with each other.
And I'm sure you sort of keep track of your participants. Are they doing well? Are they exhibiting stress or anything that's a little off and that type of thing so that you can follow
Because we like progress. To run our prevention. We like to kind of nip problems in the bud before they happen. And we know our participants really well. When a participant joins a PACE program, they could be here for 4 or 5 years. Mm-hmm. So you know all these subtle changes that happen with the participants. So you like to catch them early before they blow up into bigger problems. So you look for those subtle changes. And every team member that comes to the team meeting is treated on an equal playing field. And that's one of the things I love about a PACE organization. It's not dictated by one discipline.
Right.
We're still waiting for that to arrive. But accompanied by staff, they can go out to the memory garden, spend the nice day out there, a few hours, a few minutes, whatever the time may be. They really did a nice job designing it.
Well, people came here for their souls to be nurtured, and now they're coming for their souls and their bodies to be nurtured.
Absolutely.
So I think it's a wonderful continuum.
That's what we were talking about the last group I toured. I said, I promise you, we will be respectful, we'll do great things here.
Mm-hmm.
We'll take care of people, we'll keep them out of nursing homes and their homes where they want to be. I talked to one of the women that are coming in volunteering. I said, you can still come and do great things here.
Mm-hmm.
She's going to come back and volunteer.
Yeah.
That'd
be nice.
Yeah, it would be nice. It would be nice to have her history and her story.
Yeah, exactly.
To share. We put some benches in here. It is a long hallway to walk. Day center, the CNA staff will be providing activities over there under activity staff guidance. But initially, they'll be providing most of the activities on that side. This is a restroom here. It's not a restroom, it's a room for resting. Should clarify that.
Nice.
It's a smaller programming room. These are all recliners, so they do recline.
Absolutely.
We do have another room on the other side with a bed. I'll show you that one in the walk-by.
You can really just lay down.
It looks like.
And then there's all the beds in the.
Yeah, they look comfy.
It looks like butter.
Yeah, it does look like butter.
But it can be built into their care plan, too. All the care plans are very individualized for the participants. So the interdisciplinary team will get together and talk about the care that clients require. So if a participant was coming to the center that required a rest period every day for a half an hour just to sit down, you know, away from the crowd, put your feet up, or to lay down and take a nap every day, we build that into the care plan so that we would know at 11 o'clock every day, you know, Mary Jo needs to lay down and take a nap every day. So the CNA staff would pay attention to that, the nursing staff would pay attention to that, and then we would make sure that that would happen on a daily basis. So that could either happen in here or that could happen in the room with the bed, depending on the type of rest that was required. And what I love about this is it kind of spans room to room.
Mm-hmm.
It spans from memory care
to regular
programming. So if we had it, like one, we'll eventually have more than one nurse in here, but to start up, we have one. So,
so she can go back and forth.
Absolutely. And this is our other medication room here. So this is where medications would be dispensed during the day. If clients came in, they needed a medication. If I took a new dose of medication, I wouldn't have to miss that dose because I'm coming. Or if I couldn't take my medications alone during the day.
There's also a laundry room on site also.
This is great.
Back in the main day center.
It's really, really.
In the main day center during the day. They come in the morning, they could have like a light breakfast. If they haven't eaten breakfast, they would have that here. And then throughout the day, there's a series of activities there.
Okay.
They could go to the medical clinic and see the doctor if they had a doctor's appointment.
Okay.
They may go to rehab and work out with the rehab staff if they had a rehab need. They may see their social worker if they had any kind of social needs at all. Whether it's I'm having trouble paying my electric bill, can you help me write out checks? You know, I'm having trouble with my hands.
So inclusive.
Yeah, they could behavioral health counseling. They could go see the social worker there. They could see the dentist. Talk to the nurse about some issues that they may have. The whole staff is located right here in this building. Or they can come in for recreational activities. You know, we'll have musical groups happening. We have outside trips going on. So to go to the zoo, to the park.
And a little bit of art work maybe?
Absolutely. We have a big art program. A little bit of everything going on here. We come together for lunch. So we'll be serving lunch here, and then after lunch, activity programs continue. And we provide transportation, so they come in, you know, the van will pick them up, bring them here, bring them home. And depending on how many hours they're here during the day, some clients come in for a full day from 7 to 5 if their caregiver at home is working during the day. Some may come in for a short span if they want to just come in for the art program for a couple of hours. Our transportation will bring them in just for the art program.
So how many people can you take care of?
About 80 a day. And this site here will service about 400. So 400 people will be connected. Yeah, we're looking forward to it. Yes, absolutely. Yeah, we're thrilled.